Hey everybody, it's Pamela and I am back with another episode for you, and today I am bringing you my winter favorites. So let's get started. So I realized when I put together my favorite items for this video that a lot of them are red. And so you're gonna see a lot of red in this episode. Actually, this sweater is not one of the favorites I'm featuring, but I do love this sweater. It's a non-wool, like a heavy cotton from Ann Taylor. So in case you were wondering, but this actually isn't in the lineup. But what I do have for you today are a bunch of really cool, cozy things that are gonna keep you warm and well-dressed for the winter, so let's get right into them. The first thing I'm going to bring you out of my favorites is this puffer vest from New York & Company. I love this puffer vest because it's warm and cozy. I love the color red, as you can tell. And my sister got this for me for Christmas last year. So I went on New York & Company's website to make sure that they still have it, and they do. They have almost the exact same design. There's one difference though with last year's design and this year's, and that is this tie in the back. Now, I really love this tie because I like a more fitted look in my clothes. So this allows you to cinch the waist in just a little bit. It doesn't look too tight or form fitting, but it just allows for a little bit more tailored look. However, the design that they have this year doesn't include this tie. So really that's the only difference. It has a nice high neck to keep you cozy. It is polyester filling, so no down or anything like that. It's just super warm, super cute, and I love it. The next item in my favorites, which is also gonna keep you cozy and dry this winter, are my Hunter rain boots. And you know, Hunter's been around, I think, since the 1920s, and they say on their website that they used the original lasts that they have from then to make today's boots. So you know that you are dealing with quality when you buy a Hunter boot. And they also tell you that their boots are made of 28 different components. But really what I wanted to bring your attention to is the fact that over all the components, they overlay this rubber, which it's just one continuous piece of rubber, so it's never going to leak. And actually the reason I bought these is because my old rain boots started leaking. So I had this pair of rain boots. I had them for years and I really liked them. They were pretty. They were like this nice lime green color. But eventually they actually wore down to the point where they were leaking. So when I would go out in the rain, I'd come back with wet feet, and it was obviously defeats the purpose of having rain boots. So I got rid of those and I started looking online for really high quality rain boots. And I found Hunter, and I had heard of them before, but I'd never owned a pair of their boots. So I bought these. I will say that they are a little bit more expensive, but you're getting a boot that is fantastic quality, and this will literally last me probably decades, if not longer. It's always gonna keep your feet dry and warm. And where I live in Atlanta, we do get a little bit of snow, but in the winter time we get more rain than snow. And especially lately, it's been raining a lot here, and I've been wearing these almost every day to go outside, and I just love them. I highly recommend Hunter boots. Go check the website out and see what other products they have. They have tall boots like this, they have glossy boots, they have matte color boots, they have ankle boots, patterns. There's something for everybody. So go check them out. They also have some things on sale right now. Definitely recommend them to keep you warm. Definitely recommend them to keep you warm and cozy in the wintertime. And they're red, you can tell again, I love red. My next favorite is this French beret. And as you can see, I've already put it on for you. This hat is truly one of my favorites. I own a lot of hats, but I love this one. And I got it on Etsy from a shop called Askidas, I think it is. I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce it. The woman who makes these hats actually is from Turkey. And I was looking for a beret style hat. I love it. I just love this little pom-pom on top too. I was looking for a beret style hat in a faux wool fabric. So I didn't want cotton. I didn't want a really floppy beret. I wanted something with a little bit of structure to it that was reminiscent of wool, but not actual wool. And I actually had kind of a tough time finding that, but I finally found this hat on Etsy, and she makes a bunch of other similar hats as well. And I just absolutely adore it. It's perfect. It's exactly what I was looking for. I love the color. I love the little purple pom-pom. And I don't know if you can see, but it's got a little bit of contrast piping, purple piping here. Perfect for winter, keeps my head warm, cruelty-free, very stylish. I love the beret style. I love wearing hats in general, but this is absolutely one of my favorites and I wanted to include it today for you. So I'm gonna give you actually a link to the shop where I got it on Etsy. I checked earlier today before I started shooting this video to see what she's got going now in her inventory because I bought this earlier this year. And actually that shop is on hiatus. So you can sign up for an email when she comes back, but I will also find similar products online and link you to those so that at least if you're looking for something right now, you can find something similar to this. That's a faux wool beret style hat. I hope you love it. I know I do. Next up is this vanilla chai tea from Just Add Honey. Just Add Honey is the name of the company and it's an Atlanta-based company. So I like buying this tea to support a local company. I was actually first exposed to chai tea when I was in Africa years ago. It was a long time ago. I went on a trip there for a month and met with some local tribes people there, and they made chai tea as their main beverage. So they brewed that for us while we were there, and that's the first time I had had chai, and I really fell in love with the flavor, but I never got back into it when I got back to the States. And then I started seeing chai around, like in Starbucks and in the stores. And finally, I found this chai tea in a local restaurant in Atlanta. The restaurant is no longer in existence, but they sold this tea, and this company is, of course, still around, and I'm gonna link you to it in the description. So I decided, what the heck, I'm gonna try it and see if it tastes like what I remember chai tea tasting like. And it really does. It tastes exactly like what I remember having when I was in Africa. So it really brings back great memories. I love the flavor. If you're a chai fan, you already know it's got that really full vanilla, kind of sweet, spicy flavor to it. When I brew it, I add soy milk, a little bit of soy milk or soy creamer to it. I don't add any sweeteners. I really don't like tea with sweetener in it. I don't know, that's just my taste. So when I brew it, I add those and that's how I have it. And it's really great on a cold winter's day if you're settling in for work or you're about to watch a movie or whatever you're gonna do, read a book. I really love this. It keeps you warm from the inside and it tastes great. If you are a chocolate lover, you are going to love my next favorite, and that is this chocolate bar from Cho. I think it's pronounced Cho. It is almond and sea salt. And I don't usually go for dark chocolate. I just find it really bitter. I don't like the taste. I know it's good for you. I know I'm supposed to eat it because it has a lot of actually good qualities about it for your diet, but I've never got into dark chocolate. But I was at Whole Foods the other day and I was looking at this bar and someone who works there saw me pick it up and he asked me if I had tried it before and I said no. And he said, you've got to get it. It's really delicious. I highly recommend it. So I took his recommendation and brought it home with me. And I have to say, I agree with him. It is really delicious. Now it still does have some of that bitterness that dark chocolate has. It is dark chocolate, but it's not as bitter as almost every other dark chocolate I've tried. And the almonds and the sea salt are in there and they really balance out the flavors. It's really delicious. I definitely recommend it. But I think the best parts about this bar are that it's made with organic chocolate and it's also fair trade certified. So those are important things to me. If you're looking for an organic dark chocolate bar that is vegan, it's fair trade, I definitely recommend trying this out. Next up in my favorites are a couple of beauty items. They're gonna keep you hydrated throughout the winter. They're both from Paula's Choice. And I love Paula's Choice because they're not tested on animals. They're very effective products that really do work on your skin. They don't irritate, and most of them are vegan friendly, so they're not gonna contain any animal ingredients. Now, her whole line is not vegan friendly, unfortunately, but she does list on her website which products contain animal ingredients, and it's actually a pretty short list, so you know which ones to stay away from. She offers a lot of products, so most of them are going to be perfectly suitable for vegans. The first one I have in my favorites today is the Resist Moisture Renewal Oil Booster. And this is made with argan oil and ceramides and some other great ingredients for your skin. It is an oil booster, so you're not going to use it during the day all over your face. It's going to be a little bit oily, but it's really not oily like you think of when you think of cooking oil or something like that. It's very, very light. Since it is a booster, it's designed to be mixed with other products. You can use it alone. I use it both ways. So it comes with this eyedropper and you just take the cap off, put the eyedropper in and dispense a few drops. You can mix it with a moisturizer, which I do at night. And you can use it during the day like that too. Like I said earlier, even though it's an oil, it's not a heavy oil. It's going to be very light on your skin. And it just helps seal in moisture and add hydration. And it's got some antioxidants in here that are really good for your skin as well. So it's great if you mix it with that or mix it with an exfoliant. I also use this alone after my skincare routine at night. So I'll go through a skincare routine, and when I'm all done with my products, I put this on as a last step to seal in the moisture before I go to bed and really hydrate my skin all night long. And I really wake up with beautiful, soft skin. I love it. I love Paula's Choice. Love her line. Definitely recommend this for the winter time when there's forced air and, you know, there's dry air everywhere. Your hair's dry, your skin's dry. This will definitely help keep your skin soft and supple during the winter. Next from Paula's Choice is her Resist Triple Action Dark Spot Eraser, 2% BHA. So what this does is it fades dark spots, and it contains BHA, which is an exfoliator for the skin. No animal ingredients and not tested on animals. I really like this a lot because I live in the South. I live in Atlanta, where it's sunny pretty much year round, and the sun is stronger than in the Northern Hemisphere, which is where I'm from. So it's really easy to get splotchiness on your skin and brown spots and just some discolorations from sun exposure over time. This helps to fight the dark spots that you would get from sun exposure or just common aging. It's got hydroquinone, which is a lightening agent, but it's in a low enough concentration that it's not going to irritate your skin or cause any other problems. It's a gel consistency. I really like it to keep my skin tone even, and in the wintertime, like I said, even in Atlanta, you always have to be looking for ways to protect your skin from the sun and also correct the damage that you get from sun exposure, because no sunscreen is going to be 100% effective. So you've got to have some good skincare to fight the damaging effects of the sun, even if you do use sunscreen. And I really like this a lot, definitely recommend it. My next favorite is really not a winter item specifically, but I recently downloaded it to my iPhone. It's an app, and it's called The Daily Dozen. It's by Dr. Michael Greger. And if you're not familiar with Dr. Greger, he is an MD that has dedicated his life to studying nutrition and putting out videos, blog posts, articles, traveling the world to give talks about nutrition and about plant-based nutrition in particular. He insists on going where the evidence leads him, and that's why I love Dr. Greger. He's not all about hype, he has nothing to sell. He is all about researching the latest evidence-based nutritional information and bringing it to the public. And he's very transparent about his processes, and he's been doing this for many years. He actually started his research when his grandmother almost died of a heart attack when he was young. He didn't start the research when she was young, but that was what prompted him to study plant-based nutrition, because his grandmother was put on a plant-based diet to see as an experiment. It was experimental back then. To see if that would help her reverse her heart disease, and it did. Now that's his entire life. He came out with this app, The Daily Dozen, to help you track foods that you should be eating every day. And now I'm gonna do a more full review of this app in the next episode, so be sure and check the next episode out when it comes out. So I won't go too much into this app. I just wanted to mention it in my favorites because I think it's very, very handy to help you stay on track eating healthful foods every day. Foods that your body needs, whether you're vegan, omnivore, anything in between, you really need to be eating these 12 basic foods per day to get optimal nutrition. This is gonna help you do that. So that is it for my winter favorites. I brought a lot to you today. I've brought you some clothing, some food items, some skincare. I've tried to include a variety of items for you. This is my very first actual winter favorites, or any favorites at all. So let me know what you think. If you enjoyed this, if you discovered some new products, vegan-friendly products that you want to try, let me know in the comments if you're going to purchase any of these items, or if you have similar things, what you want to see next, if you want me to do another favorites video, anything at all that's on your mind, let me know in the comments. Please be sure to like this video and share this video and subscribe. I'll see you next time. But other than that, it's pretty much exactly, I dropped something. Very effective either way. Stop. Stop that.